Hi Libra, this is your weekly August 23rd through August 29th tarot reading. I do multiple spreads per reading. Check out the featured channel video for more details. Also, please donate to support this channel. This first spread is on new love this week. We have the Wheel of Fortune, the Sun, the World, the Fool, and the Empress. This is the best spread I've seen so far for this week. And I've done a few. You could be dealing with anybody, but what's important here is that out of five cards on the table, all five cards are major arcana cards, and these are all great, great major arcana cards. So we've got the Wheel of Fortune. It's all about starting a new cycle. So the wheel is spinning in your favor. We've got the Sun. The Sun is the happiest card in the deck. We've got the World card. This is the end of one chapter and start of a new chapter. It's kind of similar to the Wheel of Fortune in this particular spread, I think. To me personally, the World is the happy end card. So if you were single before this week, you're not going to be single anymore. You're going to be meeting the love of your life. We have the Fool here. The Fool is actually the outcome. I specifically asked what the outcome is going to be, and the Fool came out. Right? So this is you taking the leap of faith with this person, you starting this brand new chapter of your life. And we've got the Empress on the bottom of the deck. This card is just pure abundance. The Empress is one of the best cards in the deck. It's the mother of the tarot deck, so pregnancy could be on the horizon for you down the road. And the Empress is the relationship itself. It's just going to be very abundant and very warm and very loving. So yeah, this is a fantastic spread. Unfortunately, we don't see a particular person coming your way, but you gotta believe all these cards are saying this is gonna be the love of your life. This person is gonna be your last stop. You can name it any way you want, but it will just make you extremely, extremely happy, Libra. Happy for you, and congratulations. And I'm not gonna do an extended spread for this new love, which I usually do, because it's pretty clear what's gonna happen next between you and this person. The two of you are moving forward together. Libra, if you are already married or if you are in a relationship, this spread is for you. We've got the Ace of Pentacles, then we have the Five of Swords clarified by the Nine of Wands. We have the Ace of Wands, and we have the Two of Swords on the bottom of the deck. So I think you're coming out of a fight with your significant other or with your boyfriend, with your girlfriend. And I think it's kind of symbolic that we have the Five of Swords clarified by the Nine of Wands. And those two cards are surrounded by the two aces. So the Five of Swords is the fight that the two of you got into recently or about to get into. And the Nine of Wands is... one of you will be feeling guarded, one of you will be more upset than the other. The one who's going to be, whose fault this fight is, will present the other with these two aces, the Ace of Pentacles and the Ace of Wands. So this person, the offender, let's just call him or her that way, the offender will give it their best to try to bury the hatchet with you, right? These aces are amazing. The Ace of Pentacles is a golden opportunity. The Ace of Wands is a passionate new beginning. They could be giving you gifts. They could be showering you with money or whatever it is. They will pull every single trick up their sleeve. And we have the Two of Swords on the bottom of the deck. So I can interpret that two different ways. The Two of Swords could be you not being open to this person, you're being closed off. Or another meaning, another interpretation for the Two of Swords is the crossroads or a compromise, right? So this is going to be completely up to you whether you want to bury the hatchet with them or not, or if you want to compromise with them or not. But like I said, we've got two aces, two offers, and one of them is a golden opportunity. Hopefully, the two of you can bury the hatchet and resume your relationship as hopefully nothing ever happened. Let's see if anybody comes back from the past for you, Libra, this week. We've got the Eight of Cups, the Seven of Wands, Temperance. Then we have the Four of Swords clarified by the Empress. And we have the Knight of Cups on the bottom of the deck. You could be dealing with a Sagittarius or a water sign, Cancer, Scorpio, or Pisces. So somebody does want to make a comeback here. And they will offer their cup of love to you. That's what the Knight of Cups on the bottom of the deck is all about. Whenever I see the Knight of Cups, to me it personally always means that the person is either really in love with you, or they do have genuine emotions for you, authentic deep emotions. This person does really want to share their emotions with you. We have the Eight of Cups with the Seven of Wands, the first cards on the left. These cards are either symbolizing this person walking away because of a fight with you, or this is symbolizing this person coming back around. It doesn't really matter. There was something that caused this breakup, right? It must have been some kind of a fight or a disagreement or whatever it was. It still doesn't change the fact that the two of you are not together right now. So we have Temperance here. This is either a Sagittarius you're dealing with, or this is the energy of the what this person wants. They want to heal the situation, they want to bury the hatchet, they want to basically get back together. And we have the Four of Swords clarified by the Empress. This is actually the outcome. I specifically asked what the outcome is going to be, and those two cards came out. This is you. You are the Empress, male or female, absolutely doesn't matter. And you will need to take a break to think about it, you know, because Libra, yes, you are notorious for taking time to decide between different options or between different outcomes. You like to weigh things out. And I'm saying it with love. This is your one of your fortes, Libra. That's the way I see it. So yeah, you're taking a break. And the good news is that they do see you as the Empress, right? So this kind of confirms that they do want to share their feelings and emotions with you. And I think it will be up to you. Yeah, you're taking a break here, and this is up to you what you want to do with this offer to get back together. Let's talk about your work, your business, and your finances, Libra, this week. We've got the Six of Wands, we have the Queen of Pentacles, the Five of Swords, and the King of Swords on the bottom of the deck. You could be dealing with an Earth sign, Taurus, Virgo, or Capricorn, or you could be dealing with an air sign, Gemini, another Libra, or Aquarius. So I think the King of Swords in this spread is you, male or female, absolutely doesn't matter. And you are going to win some kind of a dispute or some kind of a conflict will be resolved in your favor. It could be about work finances, or it could be about your business, if you run your own business. So you're dealing with this Queen of Pentacles, an Earth sign, Taurus, Virgo, or Capricorn, or this person is good with their finances. So it could be a financial institution, you have some kind of a dispute against, or you're filing some kind of a complaint, or you are refusing to do so, and you are going to win here. The Five of Swords is, in this case, a win at any cost. And the Six of Wands, the first card on the left, this is you feeling victorious about this victory. So whatever it is, you're going to come on top, and I guess congratulations. Let's see what you're not expecting to happen, Libra, this week. We've got the Queen of Wands, the Tower, and the Eight of Cups. You could be dealing with a fire sign, Aries, Leo, or Sagittarius. Most likely you are dealing with this fire sign, Aries, Leo, or Sagittarius. The Queen of Wands, male or female, absolutely doesn't matter. Or this person is very fiery, very passionate. It could be work-related. It could be love-related. It could be pretty much related to anything. So what you're not expecting to happen is this person to suddenly walk away from you, or walk away from your workplace, because it could be your colleague. Whoever this person is, they're no longer going to be associated with you or your workplace or your business if you run your own business. Could be an employee. Somebody is just leaving your life. I don't know if they're leaving for good, or if they're just taking a break, if they're going on vacation, or if they're taking a leave of absence. But the main point here is that they're out of the blue, all of a sudden need to leave, or they're just leaving. All right, so that's what you're not expecting to happen this week. Other than that, have a great week, Libra. And there you have it. This was your tarot reading for this time period. I hope it resonated with you and helps you live a better life one way or the other. Thank you for watching, sharing, and subscribing.